मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर डूइंग द चैप्टर लिटिल गर्ल एंड ऑलरेडी आई हैव टोल्ड यू 7-8 पैराग्राफ्स. टुडे वी शैल स्टार्ट विद पैराग्राफ नंबर 9. एज इन प्रीवियस स्टोरी यू नो दैट केजिया इज़ वेरी मच अफ्रेड ऑफ हर फादर बिकॉज वन डे ही स्कॉल्डेड हर एंड पुट स्केल ऑन हर हैंड्स एंड नाउ वन डे शी वॉज वॉचिंग हर नेबरर्स द मैकडोनल्ड्स. They lived next door. They had 5 children. Looking through a gap in the fence, the little girl saw them playing tag in the evening. Tag is a children's game of catching one another. She watched that McDonald, they were neighbors. Their father, he was playing with them. And the father with the baby Mao on his shoulder, 2 little girls hanging onto his coat pockets. They ran round and round. This was also the father. He was playing. And the children, they were also laughing. They were throwing water on him. And she saw the boys turn hose on him. And he tried to catch them laughing all the time. Then it was she who decided there were different type of fathers. Now she realized that her father is different and other fathers are different. Then mother, one day what happened? Kezia's mother, she fell ill. And she and grandmother, they went to the hospital. The little girl was left alone in the house. She was all alone in the house. There was a cook in the home. Her name was Alice. She was there. That was all right in the daytime. In the daytime, the girl was okay with that cook. Now you can see, this is the picture shown by McDonald's, the neighbors. These 5 children, they are playing with their father. Therefore, Kezia realized that this father is different than her own father. She is watching from this fence. And when the mother became ill, she was all alone in her house. And when Alice, the cook, she was putting her to bed, she grew suddenly afraid. She was very much afraid. And she said, what I should do if today also I have a nightmare. Nightmare is a bad dream. She asked, often I have nightmares. And then granny, means grandmother, used to take care of her whenever she has those nightmares. So she was thinking that today is very dark and I am all alone, I will not sleep. But the cook said, oh child, just go to sleep, pulling off her socks, and don't scream and wake your poor pa. The Alice cook told her not to wake up your father as he is very tired for the whole day's work. But when the child was sleeping, the old nightmare was there. The butcher with a knife and a rope who came near. This is the nightmare which she used to see generally. That there is a butcher. Butcher is a person who, cut these animals. And he was having a knife and a rope who came nearer and nearer, smiling, that dreadful smile. There is a smile on the face of the butcher. Well, she could not move. When she was very much afraid, she didn't move from her, and she could only stand still. She was crying very badly and she shouted, Grandma, Grandma. She woke shivering to see father beside her. When she was feeling afraid of this nightmare, the father was there today, grandmother was not at home. So father she saw was standing beside her with a candle in his hand. What's the matter? He asked the daughter, what's the problem? Oh, a butcher, a knife, I want granny. And he blew out the candle. He bent down and caught up the child in his arms. Now the father, he took the girl in his arms. He carried her along the passage to the big bedroom. A newspaper was on the bed. He put away the paper. Then carefully tucked up the child. He made the child lay on the bed with him. He lay down beside her, half asleep, still with the butcher's smile all about her. It seemed she crept close to him. Now the girl who was afraid of her father, she came close to him, snuggled her head under his arm, held tightly to his shirt. She just, tightly hugged her father at night when she was feeling afraid. Tucked up means covered up nicely in the bed. Then the dark did not matter. She lay still. Now, even if there was darkness, she didn't bother. She was lying still with her father. And the father was telling her, you can rub your feet against my legs and get them warm also. Because her feet, because of, fear, they were all cool, cold. The father told her, you can rub your feet also with me. And now she was okay. That's all for today. and then you know we shall do tomorrow some question answers and the last paragraph. Thank you and have a nice day.